Okay, let's start. Welcome you to the Mech Machinery course for the third year student, ISE student, robotic and AI students. Okay, I would change the name of the course as the Mechanism Design and Simulation, and we will begin chapter one first. Okay, you see my slide, right? Okay, so this course, the name of the course is Mechanics of Machinery.But the material that I want to teach is about the design of mechanisms. It's very similar. The difference is the aspect that when we look at the mechanism. Okay, the class time will be today, every Monday, 9:30 until noon. Okay, and this year, as we have to face the COVID-19, so I think we have to handle the class.Using the virtual classroom Zoom, okay, the whole semester, okay, and there gonna be two instructor, me, Ratchathin Jajalern, and Dr. Saran, okay, we will handle this course, okay. The textbook that we gonna use, I will post the textbook, okay, in the course field, and I will give it to you by the live book, okay. About the score.About the activity, about the how we gonna grade you, okay? It's based on homework, project, midterm, and final. It means that we gonna have a midterm paper examination and final examination, 30 and 30, okay? In the next 2 months, we gonna have midterm examination, 3 hours, okay? You have to analyze design mechanism on paper, okay? In 3 hours, okay? And it's 30 marks, and at the end of the term, okay, we're gonna have a final exam 30% as well, okay. During that time, we will have a homework, and when we're gonna have a project, okay, the score for the project, I think it's quite big. It's 30 marks. The project you have to build, you have to analyze the mechanism in simulation.This year, I think we're gonna use the MATLAB SimScape multi-bodies. Okay, there is a software called MATLAB. MATLAB has a toolbox called SimScape, and inside the SimScape, there is a toolbox called multi-body. We're gonna use the multi-body to build a mechanism over there. Okay, and in that platform, you can analyze both force and motion of the mechanism. So, okay, that's the last. Idea about the course. Okay, for the course communication. Okay, sorry. I think I forget to record. Okay, we already record it. Okay. Okay, so for the class communication.We're gonna use both line group and course field. Okay, I think you are now in the line group, but if not, please join the line group and join the course field, this course as well. Okay, we're gonna use the line for the class communication. So if I have announcements, I will post my announcement in the line group, okay.The objective, okay, lastly, okay, there are 4 objectives. At the end of the course, you should be able to design a mechanism, okay? You should be able to design a mechanism, okay? And analyze the mechanism, both motion and force. And I believe that this is the first course that you're gonna learn about synthesis.So if you look for some type of motion, you should be able to synthesize, find the mechanism that fit the motion that required. And you should be able to simulate, okay, the mechanisms. Okay, if you design the mechanism, you should be able to build that one in the simulation and analyze using the numerical tools, okay?So looking at these 4 objectives, Okay, you will see that there are several aspects that the mechanism. It means that, okay, to learn about mechanism, there are many tools. Okay, to learn about how to use that tool, okay, will be different in different aspects. It means like there gonna be like a four modules here. Okay, there gonna be module number one, number two, number three, number four. Okay.In those four modules, normally it requires different skill. Okay, but we pack those tools, those modules in the same class to aim toward one thing, only one thing, to design a mechanism. So, lastly, to design mechanism, you have to be able to use several tools, and those tools may be different.When we use it, okay, you will feel that someone good when they simulate the mechanism, but may not understand how to underline it clearly. So to be able to design mechanism, you should be able to handle all the tools that we include in this course. So lastly, in this course, there gonna be like a module.Okay, in this slide, you will see four modules. The first one I call is overview. The second one I call is synthesis. The third is analysis, both force and position. And the fourth, the last one is the simulation. This week and the next week, we're gonna focus about the overview. The overview is about the fundamental of the mechanism. Okay, this topic is not difficult.But very, very important. Okay, it means that you have to understand the fundamental of the mechanism very clearly to be able to go for a synthesis or analysis. Okay, this topic is not difficult, but very, very important again. Okay, so these 2 weeks, we will focus on the overview on the fundamental first. Okay, and the next 2 weeks, you're gonna firstdesign mechanism using the concept what we call synthesis. Okay, and next month, you're gonna learn about how to analyze the motion and force on the mechanism. When we talk about the motion, we talk about the position, velocity, and acceleration. Okay, and I think the analysis part is not that easy. It's very, very difficult, okay, because the motion and force is a vector. Okay, when we deal with a vector on the multi-link body,Okay, there gonna be very, very many parameters, and all the parameter that we discuss is a vector. So it means that we gonna deal with a vector, a lot of vectors, vector analysis. Okay, so for the mechanism analysis is the big part in this course. Okay, I think you're gonna face this one in the next 6 weeks about that one, and after the midterm.We're gonna have a project. You're gonna learn about the numerical tools. Okay, you have to build the mechanism in the simulation in the MATLAB. Okay. So, since we don't have much time, let's quickly go into the detail of the course. Okay, the first thing in this course, I would like to talk about kinematic and kinetic first. Okay.Kinematics is the study of motion without regarding to force, and kinetic is the studying force on the system in motion. It means that when we talk about kinematics, we concern about only the motion. Okay, when we talk about mechanics, there are two things that we discuss when we talk about mechanics is the motion and force. But when we talk about the kinematics,We will talk about motion only. We don't care about the force that cause the motion. Okay. So if you want to analyze the relation between the force and the motion, is the side called kinetics. Okay. In this slide is very important that you understand the concept of kinematic and kinetic. It's very, very important.Because you will understand the scope of this class. This class will mainly on kinematics, okay? And you're gonna learn about kinetics on different class. Okay, this slide will talk about mechanism and machine. Okay, the mechanism is the kinematic chain with at least one link has been ground or attached to the frame of reference. The purpose of the mechanism is sometimes that we want to convert some type of motion to different type of motion. For example, the input is a circular motion. And we want to convert circular motion into linear motion. We need a mechanism. So the mechanism, the purpose is to transform one type of motion to the different type. Or we want to control the motion of something. And we're gonna use the concept of linkage, rigid body, gear train, okay, to decide how we're gonna transform one type of mechanism to the different type. A machine is a mechanism that deliver force and power. Okay, so machine is a mechanism, but there are large force, large power. So when we talk about the washing machine, the purpose of washing machine is to remove the dirty from your clothes. So you need power. So it's not only mechanism. You need power to remove that dirty. Okay, so it's the machine. Okay, so machine is the mechanism that has a large force. Okay, looking at the wiper mechanism, wiper in front of your car. Okay, is the mechanism because we concern only the motion, not the force. Okay, they are force, but the force is not that much. So the motion is more interesting. So we call the wiper is the mechanism. Okay. Okay. In the course, now you can, I will have some question for you and then I will have a 5-minute break. Okay. Now please turn on your camera and discuss about mechanism and machine. Okay. Turn on your camera. If I ask you this, the door, the sliding door, whether it's going to be a mechanism or a machine, the sliding door.
Mechanism.
Why?
Because it doesn't know force. The force is from like the user. I don't know.
How about the car? Automotive car, automotive vehicle, whether it's going to be a mechanism or a machine.
Machine teacher.
Why?
It's require the force from the engine to drive itself.
Okay. In front of the air conditioning, there gonna be a grill, right? To control the flow of the wind of your air conditioning. Whether it's gonna be mechanism or it's gonna be a machine.
Mechanism.
Why?
So motion control of the wind.
Okay. So when we talk about the mechanism, it means that the motion is the thing that we interest, not the power, not the strength of the link. Okay. So at the end, when you design something, normally typically is a machine. But when you design a machine in the curriculum, normally we separate into two subjects. The one is what we call make machinery or design mechanism. And the other subject called machine design. Okay. Design mechanism will focus on the motion only. And machine design will focus on the strength, on the force, on the the strength that the link can withstand, the rigid body can withstand those force, those power. So typically we design the course into two course, separate course. So this course will focus on only on the motion. Okay, motion control, motion design, something like that one. You have to understand this very clearly because if you don't understand the scope, you will find that this course is going to be very, very difficult. But if you understand the scope, it will help you okay, to have a very good step into the mechanism design. Look at this one. Okay, now we still in the recording, but I want you guys to participate in this aspect. Okay, in this aspect. First, do you know the name of this mechanism and who invented this one? Please participate. I want to make the class enjoyable and fun. Do you know the name of this mechanism and the one who invented this?
Steam engine.
Steam engine, yes.
By James Watt.
What year?
I have no idea now.
It's about 200 years ago.
Yeah.
I think about
1800. Yes. In 19th century, but I don't know the exact year.
Yeah. Very, very, very good. Thank you very much. We're gonna go to a very important question, I think, about the opening class, okay? 200 years ago, before that time, I think everyone at that time know that when you burn the trees, we have a sign called combustion. Okay, you can burn the tree and you get the energy. And then you can use those heat to heat the water, and water will boil, right? And we will get a stream, right? We will get a stream. Everyone at that time know that the stream has a power. The stream will be very, very hot, and they're gonna be pressures. They know that there are pressure inside the stream, but they don't know that how to convert those pressure into the things that we can use, into the things that useful. Okay. At that time, we know that the stream has the power, but James Watt is the one that know how to convert the power in the stream into something that we can use. Okay, so James Watt invent what we call steam engine. So I think the concept at that time is very inspiring. So in this picture, there are so many mechanisms. James Watt cannot use only one mechanism to convert the power inside the steam into the something that we can use. Same what invent several mechanisms. So in the first class, I will ask you 7 mechanisms in this picture. Okay, you have to list all the mechanisms in this picture that James Watt used to control the heat steam engine. Okay, you can begin by either one. What mechanism? Where is it? The purpose of that one is what?
The lever.
Which one?
Before the valve, to control the valve of the stream.
Valve number one is the valve. The purpose of the valve is what?
To open and close the stream line.
Okay, open the close, control the flow. If you open the valve, large opening, the flow will be large. Small opening, the flow will be small. So the first one is the valve, okay? Okay. I asked you 7. Now you get 1. Okay, what else?
The engine.
Engine, stream engine. The purpose is?
To convert the steam pressure into the movement.
What type of movement? Linear.
Linear.
Okay.
Movement of the shaft.
We call this move reciprocating move. We call this move reciprocating move. So if the pressurized vapors get into the steam engine, the piston inside will back and forth in the linear motion. So if we go this way, it opens one valve, and it will switch the direction of the pressurized vapor and will push the piston into the different direction. So the piston will move back and forth, we call this one reciprocating. Okay, so the steam engine, the input is the pressurized vapor, the output is the reciprocating motion, okay? We call this one steam engine. Now we get to mechanisms, okay? What else?
The linkage.
Which one?
The one that connects the engine to the big wheel.
Okay. Do you know the name? Do you know the purpose of this one?
To change the linear motion into rotational motion.
Okay. The purpose is to convert one type of motion to different types. If the purpose is to convert the linear, the reciprocating motion into the rotary motion, right? And continuous rotary motion, one direction motion. Okay. So this mechanism called inward slider crank. This mechanism has a name called inward slider crank. So this slider will go back and forth and the wheel will rotate in one direction continuously. So now we have three mechanisms, okay? What else? I asked you
the wheel. The wheel, teacher. To the big wheel and connect to the small wheel. In the shaft.
Okay, call what? This one mechanism. This mechanism.
Call the chain.
Chain belt. Chain
belt.
Okay. Belt or chain. Okay. The purpose is.
To provide the faster velocity to the different shaft.
Not exactly. Why we need belt? We used to transfer the mechanism to another location far away, right?
Oh yeah.
This shaft and this shaft may be not in the same place. It's maybe a little bit far. So we use the belt concept to transfer one location of motion to another location of motion. Okay, we use belt. Okay, four. Okay, about 5, 6, 7.
Gear.
The purpose is what?
To change the orientation of the spin, of the rotational motion of the gear.
Change the direction, right? Change the direction of motion. So the input is rotation, the output is rotation, but the direction gonna be different. So the input gonna be in the about horizontal plane. The output is what?
Vertical.
Vertical against the gravity. The output gonna be vertical against gravity. Okay. This is called bevel gear. This is one type of gear called bevel gear. So now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 already. Okay. About 6 and 7.
The metal spheres.
So the purpose is
to store the energy, the rotational energy as a inertia.
To store energy for what?
Like to store it while it's spinning, the energy of the shaft.
Why they need to store the energy? Why?
Not sure actually.
Actually, this is the, I think the most interesting mechanism in this picture is what we call flyball governor. It's the most interesting one in the picture. So the purpose of the flyball is what? Can you guess? Why they need a metal sphere?
to lift the meter, the measurable meter.
Yeah. Up. Why they lift? Why it lift when they rotate? Why?
Is the centrifugal force?
Centripetal force, right?
Centrifugal.
When it's rotated, there's gonna be a rotational force, centripetal force, centrifugal force, right?
Yeah.
And the sphere will rotate against the gravity. So the weight of the sphere is the same. It means that the gravity force is about the same. But the centrifugal force will depend on the speed of the rotation, right? So when they rotate, the ball gonna be balanced in the dynamic balance. So it will lift to balance the force, the gravity force and the centripetal force. So this mechanism called the fly ball. So, okay, I think James Watt is really genius. He developed what we call the sensor, speed sensor at that time. They have to send the speed of the rotation. They use the concept that they use the fly ball to rotate and generate the centrifugal force against the gravity force. And the position of the fly ball will represent the speed of the rotation. Okay, this one called the fly ball governor. Okay, number six. And when this mechanism lift, when it rotates, I think this push will lift up. And there's gonna be a beam here, a beam here. When this beam lifts up, this will push down, it will close the valve. Okay, so if the speed is too much, if the speed is too fast, the valve will close. If the speed is too slow, the valve will open. So at that time, James Watt developed a speed sensor using a mechanism. Then he developed a mechanism to send the speed. And he developed, I think it's the very first closed loop control system. It's the very first closed loop control system. If we send the speed, if the send speed is too fast, it shut the valve. So it's the closed loop control system. So in this manner, James Watt can control the speed of the rotation, and they use this design to operate the steam engine train. Okay, the train operated by steam engine. If you don't have the mechanism that can control the speed, you cannot control the speed of the train. How fast it's gonna move? It's gonna be very, very dangerous. So at that time, we develop steam engine and we can control the power of the steam engine so that the speed of the vehicle gonna be the same. Okay. Again, in this picture, there are about 7 mechanisms. So this mechanism really inspired engineer at that time until now. This represents that it means that when we have to invent something, normally we have to invent several mechanisms to prove, to demonstrate that our concept works. Okay, this is still true until nowadays. So when you discover something and you want to demonstrate your concept, you have to develop a lot of mechanisms, okay, to demonstrate that your concept works. James Watt proved that he can use the power from the stream and he can control the power, those power, okay? Look at this one, the car suspension. I will ask you this one. The suspension is a mechanism or a machine? Whether it's a mechanism or a machine, the suspension?
Mechanism.
Why?
Because it's just a support to support the force.
You know what
about it does not provide the force.
Okay, about the car suspension, it's gonna be whether in the homework or in the exam. If it's not in the homework, normally it will be in the examination. So every year in the Thai program, because the car suspension is a very good concept when we design a mechanism. I will ask you again about the suspension. Machine is a mechanism that deliver a large force, that deliver a large power. How about the force in those linkage? Is it large or is small? About the force within the link, within the rigid body, whether it large or small. They have to withstand the whole body of the car, right? But yes. Why? It's large, right? It's large, not small. But why we call this one mechanism? Why? Why we call the suspension a mechanism? Why?
It doesn't have a power source.
It doesn't have a power source. A machine is a mechanism that deliver a large force, deliver a large power. In this case, I think the force is large, not small. But the motion is a big, a lot more interesting. So the motion, when you design the motion of the suspension, is gonna be very challenging task. You have to make sure that when the car stay on the road, stay on not the flat load, a rough load, a tough load, all the four wheels will touch the those load, those ground. Okay, all the wheels will touch the ground. The mechanism will guarantee that all the wheels will touch the ground and distributed force equally as much as possible. So to design the mechanism, to design those mechanism is going to be very, very difficult task. They're going to use several rigid body, several joints, several links, so that to guarantee that the wheel will touch the ground. So to design the motion, very, very difficult. That's why we call this one a mechanism. Even this mechanism accept, sustain a large force. Okay, but the motion is more difficult. So we call the car suspension a mechanism. Again, may I ask you this one? What is the purpose of the suspension? Again, please tell me. Because I will ask you this one in the homework or in the exam anyway. What is the purpose of the suspension? Again.
To make sure all the wheels touch the ground.
Okay, exactly. That's one purpose. What about the other purpose?
And equally distribute the forces.
Yes. Thanks. Yeah, that's very good. But typically there are two purposes. One purpose is to make sure that all the wheels distribute the force, touching force equally. The other purpose is what?
Made the customer more comfortable.
Yes. They suppress what? Vibration, right? Because when the wheel touch the ground is not that flat, that smooth. So the wheel will lock, move up and down at the high frequency. So we don't want those motion to go to the passenger. The passenger must sit comfortably. Don't see that oscillating motion. So the purpose of the suspension is to suppress the vibration, the locking motion, the oscillatory motion of the wheel. Okay, suppress those motion so that the one behind the handle will not see those oscillating motion. So there are two purposes. Okay. Any question about this suspension mechanism? Any question? Okay, I will give you one more thing and then we will have about 5 minutes break, okay? I will skip this one. I will skip this one. Okay. Again, look at this one. Who know the name of this robot and the purpose and what gear they operate? Please. The name of the robot, the gear that they operate, and the purpose of this robot. Now, Robert.
Is it a perseverance?
The one before that, the grandpa, I think the grandpa of the surveillance. The name is what?
Curiosity.
The father of curiosity. What year?
Uh, 1997.
Exactly, yes. The name is what?
I think Sojourner.
Sojourners. I think that the robot concept is very, very inspiring. I think this robot inspired several engineers later, okay? The Mars rover, the name of the rover is called Sojourner in 1997, okay? When NASA sent this robot to Mars at that time, okay? The thing is that before that time, I think NASA sent satellites to orbit around the Mars, okay? First, several years before that time, and know that the surface of the Mars is not the same as the surface of Earth. It's the sand, it's the rocky surface, okay? It's the surface that contains sand and rocky, rock, a lot of rock. Okay, so NASA want to design a robot that can travel around the Mars surface. The thing is that NASA don't use the mechanism on Earth. There are several mechanisms on Earth that used to travel around the Earth surface. For example, four wheels, two wheels, tanks, big foot, legs. There are several mechanisms that we use on Earth to walk on the surface of Earth. And it's proved 100 years, more than 100 years, and it's okay. And we know about the performance very well about those mechanisms. But when the NASA sent the robot to Mars, they don't use the mechanism that's used on Earth. They use six wheels. I will ask you this one, why? Why they don't use four wheel? Why they don't use a tank? Why they don't use a big foot? Why? They developed the mechanism that never used before. But yes, they developed a Mars-like surface on Earth to test their robot on Earth first, yes, yes. To make sure that they can operate this robot on Mars. Yeah, but they don't use the mechanism that exists before. I will ask you why they need the new type of mechanism to travel on the Mars surface. Why?
The difference in gravity.
In gravity. You mean that if the Earth we have different gravity, you will need different mechanism.
Could be.
But I think that what they talk about this one is that we know that the surface of on Mars is sand and rocky surface. The surface is a rocky surface. It contains rocks. So why they need six wheels? The mechanism is called locker bogey. There are several.
For stability.
Why? I think four wheel is enough. Why? I think the locker bogey mechanism is very inspiring because this is the first time that we see a new type of mechanism that the human use when they face a new type of application, when they face the new mission, when they face a new mission, they develop a new mechanism. That happens all the time. I think this is not the only case. This is just one case, but typical case. When human face new mission, they develop new mechanism. Okay. Lastly, the four-wheel vehicle, you have to make sure that all the wheel touch the ground and have enough touching force to make sure that the wheel can deliver force to push the vehicle forward, right? And it's very difficult to design a suspension to guarantee that the four wheel will touch the ground at equally force, have equally touching force. So in the rocky surface, it's very dangerous if the wheel stuck in those rocky surface and the robot have to climb those rocks. Maybe the rock will be very big, it's a big rock. So NASA developed a mechanism called Locker Bogey. Okay, this robot can climb a rocky. If the rock is bigger than the robot can still climb those rocks. Okay, so all the wheels, there are motor inside those wheels. It means that all the wheels have a thrust, can push the robot forward. Okay, so the NASA developed the mechanism called Locker Bogey and used never before used mechanism called Locker Bogey to design a Sojourner 20 years ago and send those robots to Mars. I think the robot survived several months and then at the end it's stuck and cannot move. Okay. So it means that it worked, but only for a while. One thing that the problem is that there are about 8 minutes when we communicate with the robot. So we send the command to the robot will move and we will see what happened. And if the robot stuck on some rock, we cannot change, we cannot correct it, okay? So NASA know the problems, okay? Look at this one. This is the newest one, right? Do you know the name of this robot? This is the last year robot that NASA sent to Mars, right? The name is what? Can you find the name for me?
Perseverance.
Perseverance. They still use the Locker Bogey suspension, right? But now you see that they have the arm that hold a lot of mechanisms at its hands. They have the a pole that hold the sensors. Now the robot 20 years later is a lot more complicated and bigger in terms of size. Okay. I think NASA still believes in the Locker Bogey suspension. But this time, I think NASA sent the quadrotor as well, right? The drone with the robot as well, right? Because if there is a drone, the drone does not have to face the problem of the surface. They can fly on the on the air, okay? So I think this mission, they send the drone as well, okay? So in this example, I want to tell you that every new mission, we have to develop a mechanism and several mechanisms. And it's the purpose of this class that you learn about how to design mechanism. At the end of the class, you still cannot design a complex mechanism. But the class is the first step because you're gonna learn the fundamentals. You're gonna learn the fundamental concept before you go to the complicated task. So we will learn about the fundamental of mechanism, the scope, the vocabularies, the tools that we can use. And we're gonna use simple case first in class to make sure that you understand the concept. So the class will focus on the concept. Okay, now I think I will stop share and